With more on the school shooting in Connecticut, joining me now is Cynthia Jevedon from the Ohio Response Team, and Nanook is joining us as well. Cynthia, you unfortunately have been on scene about dealing with tragedies like we're seeing in Newtown. How do you even begin to address the immediate needs of such intense grief?
Certainly, as the initial trauma is exposed to children and parents and people at the schools, it's really an opportunity for those professionals in the area to make outreach so that they can start formulating teams that can come and respond, break down into different groups so that they can identify and determine what area of focus those different groups need to be working on and really be able to get those in place as soon as they can.
And how do you even start talking with a child about something like this, whether they saw it firsthand, like so many little ones did today, sadly, or ones at home tonight in the Miami Valley? How do parents begin a conversation and talk about something like this?
Certainly, we would encourage parents to be able to participate in viewing of coverage with their children so that they can screen for age appropriate, different news blitz that they might be seeing, and then talking with them about the issues, again, age appropriate, offering information that is going to help establish their safety, allowing them an opportunity to be able to ask questions and to be able to reach out to the parents, family, and other loved ones, but then also not feeling like they need to offer too much information. We know that children are going to react and respond in a variety of different ways, and we don't want to overwhelm them with what information adults may feel compelled to provide.
Right, great advice. And talk to me a little bit about Nanook and how he helps the situation.
Nanook is a facility dog that has been working with us at our Child Advocacy Center, where I'm also employed, since February. And dogs like Nanook can certainly go out into the field and work in crisis situations, really to help bring a sense of calm and comfort to those that have experienced tragedy and trauma. And we know that it can do a lot to decrease blood pressure and just really allow some different focus with those that have experienced traumatic events.
And just finally, what is the takeaway for folks here at home tonight? What can they do to maybe say something to somebody experiencing pain, or internally, how can they take it in?
Stay connected as a family. It's going to be important for children to feel that they are safe in their family unit, whatever that unit might be. Again, allowing themselves to be open for children to be able to have them come to them to speak to. And then also just make sure that they can continue to provide that educational piece and know that there are psychologists, psychiatrists, and counselors that they can find if they think that they need some additional assistance.
Help with the conversation that is so difficult, but unfortunately, in this day and age is so relevant.
Exactly.
And we do need to talk about it.
Very
All right.
True.
Cynthia Jevedon and Nanook from the Ohio Response Team, thank you so much for joining us
today.
Thank
you.